Okay, let us start with this topic, Z transform. The first equation, what I have written over here, it is for double-sided Z transform. That means if some discrete Fourier transform is being given to us, which is dependent on number of samples. So if we will do this Z transform, we will go from minus infinity to plus infinity, and it is known as double-sided Z transform. This double-sided Z transform may be infinite or may be finite. It is maybe infinite or it is maybe of finite. Now, the important factor is, what is Z? Z equal to e to the power st, where this s is the complex frequency which can be rewritten as sigma plus j omega. And how we can plot this? This is the sigma axis, this is the j omega axis, and in between this, this will be the z plane. Sorry, this will be the s plane. What is this t? T is nothing but fundamental time period. Now the second equation, whatever I have written over here, this second equation for one-sided causal. And when this one-sided causal, we are knowing which is depending, where the output is depending on the past value of input. And what is the condition for that? Xn equal to 0, that means it will be a finite one. And when n is lesser than 0, let me tell you once again that one-sided causal, this is also of two types. One is infinite and one is finite. Then the third equation, of course this is anti-causal or non-causal, where the output is depending on present and future value of the inputs. So that we have given over here for n greater than equal to 0, and for xn equal to 0, that means it is a finite signal. This will be the limit, minus infinity to minus 1. So this is for, this particular thing is for anti-causal. Now for this also there will be two things. One is of infinite duration and another is of finite duration. Then if we will come to the conclusion for region of convergence, where actually all this summation will be converging towards a particular region, then that particular thing is known as region of convergence. Let us consider that if this is the Z plane, this is, suppose this is imaginary Z, this is the real Z. Let us suppose the region of convergence is over here, the ROC. There will be an unit circle which is having the value of 0, that means one root at z equal to 0, which is having the value of 1, that is the pole at z equal to 1, and the region of convergence is lying over here. It's just like a ring structure. Is just, see over here, it's just like a, this region of convergence is being placed over here, and it is nothing but the Z plane. So what is this R? This R is that small radius. If we will replace this z equal to r e to the power j omega, y e to the power j omega terms we are taking, omega is nothing but complex frequency. Or we can say that is angular frequency. Where omega equal to 2 pi f. Because exponential signal is the most stable signal. So if we will just replace z by r e to the power j omega, then x to the power n will be r to the power n e to the power j omega n into z to the power minus n. So we can write like this. R to the power n, z to the power minus n, e to the power j omega n. This will be the figure. Now let me tell you, this e to the power j omega n will not be over here, because we are representing, we are just doing this thing. So x to the power n, x of just making one mistake, x of n r to the power n e to the power j omega n will be coming over here. So here actually this term will be coming like this, x of n r to the power n e to the power j omega n. So as because this is absolutely summable, which is the first property for region of convergence, so x to the power n r x of n r to the power n, if we will find this magnitude from n equal to minus infinity to plus infinity, it should be less than that of infinity. It will be absolutely summable product, and then only the region of convergence will be coming. So it is telling that x of z converges uniformly. X of z means this one, the z transform, it converges uniformly if and only if the ROC, that means the region of convergence of the z transform, that is x of z of the sequence, includes the unit circle. Just see over here, this is the unit circle. This is the unit circle. This full thing is the unit circle because the radius is 1. Includes the unit circle so that the ROC of x of z consists of a ring. This is like a ring structure in the z plane, centered about the origin. Centered about the origin. That is, the ROC of the z transform of x of n has values of z for which x of n r to the power minus n, of course here minus sign will be coming, that I have given, that I should given over here, x of n r to the power minus n, the magnitude of this thing should be less than infinity. So that is the first property of ROC. What is the second property of ROC? Just see over here, the region of convergence starts beyond this pole. That means beyond this, z equal to beyond this point. That means beyond this z equal to 1. That's why it does not contain any pole. Now, if x of n is finite, that means if x of n is 0, then the ROC of the entire z plane, ROC will be the entire z plane, except where it will not be present. Except possibly at z equal to 0 and or z equal to infinity. Now, if x of n is right-handed sequence, then in that case, the ROC will not include the infinity. if x of n is left handed sequence, then the ROC will not include 0. If x of n equal to 0 for all n greater than 0, then the ROC will include z equal to 0. Now, if x of z is rational, then the ROC extends to infinity, that is, the ROC is bounded by poles. If x of n is causal, then of course the ROC includes z equal to infinity. If x of n is anti-causal, then ROC should include z equal to 0. So all these are the properties of ROC. Now let us come with those figures first. First, we will start with causal, and that is of finite duration. Let us start with that thing first. So, causal, finite. So, this is causal finite. What will be the ROC? For this, this will be the ROC. This will be the ROC. The ROC will be the entire claim excepting which exclude z equal to 0. So this is causal finite, number one. Number two, anti-causal or non-causal finite. What will be the graphical representation? This is imaginary z, this is real z. For this, what will be the representation? The representation will be like this. First, let us see the graphical representation. This is imaginary z. This is real z. So, if we will do for this, then like this. This is real values as z. This is imaginary z. is ROC. So in this case, the ROC will be the entire z plane except z equals to infinity. So this is nothing but z plane. Here also this is nothing but z plane. Now if it is two-sided, two-sided means this is imaginary z, this is real z. Sequence. For this, what will be the ROC representation? This is imaginary z, this is real, this is the location for ROC, this is z plane, this point is z equal to 0. So ROC will be present everywhere except two points at z equal to 0 and z equal to infinity for this. So except z equal to 0 and z equal to infinity, the ROC will be present everywhere. So this is for all terms which are finite. This is also two-sided finite. Now what will be if I will come to the, this is the third one actually, not the second one, third one. If I will come to the fourth picture and causal infinite, then it will be going like this. This is causal infinite. What will be the figure of ROC then? Now if I will go for anti-causal infinite, what will be the ROC in this case? This is V. So, ROC of C will be present over here. Region of convergence, this is Z plane, this is imaginary Z, this is real Z. So for this, what will be ROC? ROC will be less than that of the radius of the unit circle. Clear? Now if I will go for, this is anticausal infinite. If I will go for two-sided infinite, then what will be the pattern? Then what will be the pattern for this? This is imaginary Z, this is real Z. So in that case, ROC will be less than A, greater than B. What will be the picture? This is the location of ROC. This is Z plane. This is A. And this one is B. So this will be the figure for two-sided infinite. So we completed the six things over here. Now there are several properties. Let us also write those properties over here. Properties of Z transform. The first one is the transformation. That means if x of n is the discrete time Fourier signal, then x of z will be equal with this is, remember, this is for causal. Now if I will go for the inverse transformation, and if for inverse transformation, if this is given to us, then it will be transformed to x of z. Now third one is the linearity. If we are writing it like this, then the fourth one is time reversal. Then the fifth one is time shifting. time reversal, you just change C over here, the sign is being replaced by negative 1 instead of positive 1. Linearity, when there are two discrete time Fourier signals and when they are multiplied with different coefficients, say A1 and A2. Now time shifting. It can be a right shift for that n equal to k. Or it can be a left shift for that n equal to minus k. So now if I will write the sixth property as convolution, where there will be multiplication of Fourier transform. Then I can write the seventh one. Seventh one is correlation. There are two, autocorrelation and cross correlation, already we learned in communication. Then coming to the 10th one, time differentiation. For time differentiation, if I will write it like this, then it will be converted to then time integration. Initial value theorem. theorem. So, first transformation, that means from discrete Fourier transform to Z transform. Second one, inverse transformation, that means now we will retrieve the original signal back from Z transform to Fourier transform. Third one is linearity, when there are two different discrete Fourier time signals and they are multiplied by two different coefficients and then added up, then this will be the transformed scripture. Then time reversal, if n is replaced by minus of n, then this will be the form. Then time shifting, if it will be right shifting so that n equal to k, or left shifting so that n equal to minus k, then these are the two forms given over here. Then convolution, if x1 of n and x2 of n are two different discrete Fourier transform and they are being convoluted with each other, so there will their multiplication product in Fourier transform that we will convert into Z transform. After that, correlation, if there will be x1 of n and x2 which is being shifted by an amount of L in minus infinity to plus infinity region, so what will be the convolute form, x1 of z, x2 of z inverse. Then after that, scaling, if x of n is a discrete Fourier transform and that is being multiplied by a to the power n, this n may be any value from 1 to infinity or from minus 1 to minus infinity, then this will be the transform. Then differentiation, if we have to do the differentiation of n x of n, then this will be the transform from. Then we are coming to time differentiation, if x of n and x of n minus 1 both of them are equal, then this will be the transform figure. Then time integration, if x of k is some discrete time, is some discrete time Fourier transform from the limit k equal to 0 to infinity, so this is the time integration figure. Then initial value theorem, when in the limit of n tends to 0, we are taking for x of n, so the transform figure will be x of z, of course this is the magnitude, z tends to infinity. Then final value theorem, if the opposite one we will do over here, if we will place over here infinity, then there we will find x of z that will be multiplied with z minus 1 divided by z, limit that z tends to 1. So now after all these 13, we are coming to the 14th one. And the 14th one is time delay. And that delay is possible for any side. That's why I am writing over here one-sided Z transform not possible for both of them. In time delay, if that means in this case, this will be a right shift, so it will be now do the right shift. instead of right shift, if I will do the left shift, time advance, these are all the formulas for time delay and time advance for Z transform. So all of them are coming under the properties of Z transform. Now let us do some problem over here. Depending on this Z transform, let us do some numerical problems over here. Suppose the question is being given to you, determine the Z transform of the signal below, and it is given as x of n, question number 1, x of n equal to 6 delta n plus 1 plus 5 delta n. Delta n, even knowing impulse response whose value is 1 at n equal to 0, plus 2 delta n minus 3 plus 5 delta n minus 4 plus 7 delta n minus 8. So now how we will do this thing? For x of z, which is z transform of x of n, it will be coming like this: z transform of 6 delta n plus 1 plus 5 delta n plus 2 delta n minus 3 plus 5 delta n minus 4 plus 8 plus 7 delta n minus 8. Then we will use linearity property over here. 6 z transform of delta n plus 1 plus 5 z transform of delta n plus 2 z transform of delta n minus 3 plus 5 z transform of delta n minus 4 plus 7 z transform of delta n minus 8. We are knowing the z transform of delta n is 1. We are knowing the z transform of delta n plus 1, that is given over here. That is nothing but what? Here the value of, suppose if this is delta n plus k, n equal to minus k, then z to the power minus k. Suppose for this one, n equal to minus 1. Right? Let us suppose it is in the form of delta n minus k. So what we will write over here? Z transform of delta n minus k will be equal with z to the power minus k. The value of k is minus 1, so z to the power minus of minus 1, z to the power 1 is z. That's why it will be 6 into z to the power 1 plus 5 into 1 plus 2. Similarly for this, what we will get over here, z to the power, because the value of n equal to 3, so z to the power minus 3 plus 5 z to the power minus 4 plus 7 z to the power minus 8. Now how we will represent this thing in z transform? We will represent this thing like this, as because 5 is in n equal to 0, so this here 6 coefficient. Then for z to the power minus 1 nothing is there, z to the power minus 2 nothing is there, z to the power minus 3 2 is there, z to the power minus 4 5 is there, z to the power minus 5 nothing is there, z to the power minus 6 nothing is there, z to the power minus 7 nothing is there, z to the power minus 8 7 is there. So this is the form. Clear? Suppose now I am going from question number 1 to question number 2. The question is given to us. Suppose this is the question. 0, 8, 7, 5, 9, 4, 3, 2, 1. How we will write the Z transform? If no arrow sign will be given over here, we will assume this as Z, as at n equal to 0, this is the origin. So first 0 will come over here, after that 8 z to the power minus 1, 7 z to the power minus 2 plus 5 z to the power minus 3 plus 9 z to the power minus 4 plus 3 z to the power minus 5 plus 2 z to the power minus 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, sorry, 1 is missing, 8, 7, 5, 9, this one is 4 is given over here, 4, then this one is 3 given over here, 3, plus 2, z to the power minus 7, plus 1, that means z to the power minus 8. So this will be the answer. Now let us do one more problem. Say, if the problem is given like this to you, that find the value of x of z is if x of n equal to sin omega naught n for n greater than equal to 0. So how I will do this thing? So the answer will be in this form. X of n equal to sin omega naught n means this will be the thing. Using the transform, for n greater than equal to 0, z to the power a of n, we are knowing this thing, it is 1 divided by 1 minus az inverse, or rather we can say z divided by z minus a for z greater than a. Therefore, for n greater than 0, z transform of e to the power j omega n, it will be 1 minus here, what is the value of A? A is 1 over here. Similarly, for n greater than 0, this value will be 0. Therefore, x of z equal to z transform of sin omega naught n, which will be further equal to z transform of 1 by 2 j e to the power j omega n minus e to the power minus j omega n, which can be written as 1 by 2 j 1 minus e to the power j omega naught minus 1 by 2 j 1 minus e to the power minus j omega naught . If we will advance further, we can do the crosswise multiplication over here. The final product will be like this: z inverse sine omega naught divided by 1 minus 2z inverse cos omega naught plus z to the power minus 2, which can be written as z sine omega naught plus 1, and this will be possible for z greater than 1. We have to just check it over here. Maybe it will be sine. Just check over here. So like this, we have to do all these problems. Thank you very much. Tomorrow, we will do another set of problems for Z transform. And then, we will do the inverse of Z transform. And after inverse of Z transform, there are three: 1 by partial fraction method, 1 by long division, 1 by residue method. We will do little bit of random variables. Thank you very much.